Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Virtues Last, I mean Danganronpa 2. And welcome to the final dead room, or back to the final dead room. It's an escape game. We gotta get out of here. We got some pliers. We got a bunny rabbit bear thing that Monokuma Abomination made. And, yeah, we're in here and we gotta get the fuck out, or whatever. So we gotta watch the views. Wait, watch the what? Watch the news. That's an N. Looks like a V, but then there's a little thing hanging there. So anyway, yeah, in the last episode, we are playing as Nagito now, randomly. I don't know what that's all about. I mean, I do know what that's all about. Everybody got split up, but I mean, does that just mean we're gonna have to piece together everything with Nagito and Hajime's pieces in the trial? I assume so. But anyway, we're on our way to trial number 4, trying to figure out who killed my boy Nekomaru, and to do that, we need to figure out this room, because this is clearly where the weapons came from. Okay, so let's start looking around some more. We got a big 6 on the wall. There's something written in blood on the wall. Is it? It's the number 6! These blood symbols alone don't make sense, but maybe if I combine them with something else. Okay. I didn't even check that last episode. Last episode I checked in the drawers already, but I did not check that. Can I check that up there? Something written in blood. Okay, so just the number 6. Oh, there's a 7 over here. There's something written in blood on this wall. I can see the number 7! These blood symbols alone don't make sense, but maybe if I combine them. So we got a 6, we got a 7. I don't know. Let's, I guess we'll check this, even though we know it's just the door. We have a problem. These iron doors are blocking the door. As long as we don't do something about these zones, we won't be able to escape from this room. Cool. Alright, we also found this bear. We already squeezed it. If you squeeze the stomach, it says Monokuma lines. That's all we care about there. Let's check the bed. There's something shining under the bed. I can't reach it. Looks like the bed is fixed to the floor. I can't even move it. Is there something thin and long? I don't know. I have pliers. Anyway, I also see more numbers. I also see a line on the wall that says watch the news. It says watch the news in blood.
I might just get cursed just by looking at it.
It's just a secret code. Plus, it's a pretty common one.
Secret code? Nagito, do you happen to know what this means?
Yeah, it's a common riddle. What? Watch the news is a common riddle? Okay. There's a 3 over here. Something written in blood on the wall.
Looks like it's the number 3.
These blood symbols don't make any sense. Okay, so we got a 3. We got a 6. We got a 7. We got one more number around here somewhere. I don't see a 4th number. Do I? No, I don't. Let me, what? What is this again? Watch the news in blood. I might get cursed just by looking at it. It's just a secret code. Plus, it's a pretty common one. Oh. Is this supposed to be letters? I mean, numbers? No. That can't be it, can it? What numbers would they be, right? What's a W? I don't even know. I don't know. Let's examine this thing. We haven't looked at this yet. Okay. This was also a 4-digit code, huh? But it looks like you can change the numbers with this one.
Alrighty!
This time around, let's try the 999 combinations!
I'll leave that mindless work to you, Monami.
I'll decline as well.
Password to open this. I have a feeling that the hint is close by. I should try inputting something. Sure. Watch the news. I'm thinking... Oh shit, you can open the closet. Alright, hold on. There's a number 5 in here. Hold up. There's something written in blood at the back of the closet.
Looks like the number 5.
These blood symbols don't make any sense, but if I combine them, something... There's also a hanger hanging in the closet. Might be useful for something, so I should grab it. Oh, long and skinny. We can probably use that to grab the shiny thing underneath the bed. Didn't really think about that, but that is probably the case. So I'm gonna use this. Wait, what did it say? If I straighten it out, it'll become a thin stick. Well, that'll be perfect for the shiny thing under the bed. Can't reach it, blah, 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 can't move it. guess there is something thin and long. Can we use? Okay, here we go. Here we go. Use there. Yeah, there we go. Can't reach it. Use the hanger. What the? Oh, maybe I have to. Oh, here we go. Use pliers on the hanger. Aha! There we go. Now we can use it. Weird, but alright. Can't do it with your bare hands. Alright, we got the desk.
Maybe we can escape with this, Nikito.
Who knows? I hope so. Anyway, we got the key to this, so let's open this bitch up, shall we? I don't know why it opens up a little window. Anyway, open that door. Open that drawer, I mean. Scissors? If you
use these to cut the iron bars.
You're joking, right? Or is that supposed to be an indirect hint?
I'm sorry.
Okay, so we got some scissors. Got it. Oh, there's a number on the floor, too. I didn't even see that. Number four. Number, huh? It looks like a different symbol to me. Like, for instance, a symbol that you often see on maps. It does? What symbol is that? News, north, east, west, south. Got it. So wait, what's considered north? Oh! This is telling me which way is north. Oh my god. That is so genius. Wow, okay. Well, okay, but does this tell me that behind me is north, or in front of me is north? I guess behind me would be north. So if this way is north, then it'd be 3, east would be this way, 3, 6, 7, what was it, 5? 3, 6, 7, 5? Let's give it a shot. Let's give it a shot. If not, we'll just assume that I have the numbers backwards. So, 3, 6, 7, 5. 3, 6, 7, 5. Okay.
Damn it.
Okay. So, if that's not the case, we'll assume this is north then. In which case, it would be 7, 5, 3, 6. Right? Oh, east, west, south. Wait, hold on. It's not south. Okay, sorry. Let me try that again. So if this is north, this would be north would be 3. East is 6. So 3, 6, 5, 7. Sorry. Oopsies. No. I'm trying to click on this. It's a weird interface, point-click adventure style, but it's fine. So what did I just say? 3, 6, 5, 7? 5, 7.
No,
okay. So, okay. If that's not north, and this is, so let's do northeast, west, south from there. So this would be 7, 5, 6, 3. 7, 5, 6, 3. Let's give that a shot. One more try. 7, 5, 6, 3. No? Okay, I need to understand this symbol then, because this symbol is what's throwing me off right now. What is this symbol supposed to be? Clearly, this is the thing that's supposed to tell me which direction is north. Because once I know that, I can do news easily. North, east, west, south. Because north, this would be east, right? I'm just making sure I have my east and my west right. So the real question is which way is north, and why am I so confused by it? Stop clicking on the goddamn thing. I'm trying to figure out what the hell this symbol means. Do I need to look at a fucking map? Do I need to look at a map so I can understand what that symbol is? What if I just look up map? Image. Map. Huh. I don't know. Map. Yeah, usually it's like this. The only symbol I see on a map usually is that little circle thing that, like, is a compass, basically. So, what the fuck? What the actual fuck? What does the symbol mean? I don't know what the symbol mean. What's the symbol? Number four. Looks like a symbol to me. Instance, a symbol that you often see on maps. I mean, yeah, but how can I tell which way is north? That's my only problem right now. I mean, I would assume that the fatter arrow is north. That would make sense. And if that's the case, then this is north, this is east, this is west. 3657. I've tried 3657. So, let me double check if this was a 5. This was a 5, right? Alright. It's definitely a 5. Okay, I was just making sure that that was definitely a 5. So, so 3657 I've tried. 7563 I've tried. Haven't I? I did try 7563, right? I did, right? I did try 7563. I better have. Pretty sure I did. I definitely tried that. What is this right here? It's like a little, I don't know what this little, like, notch is right here. Okay, I'm still confused as to why or what I'm doing wrong here. Do you have a hint, Monami?
That safe is a toughie. Did you figure it out, Nagito?
The numbers on the wall are definitely the password for the safe. I just need to look at those numbers by watch the news. North, east, west, south. That's what I did.
I see.
Let's input it while you're at it.
It's really simple. Yeah, I got that already. So the hint is exactly what I figured, but the problem right now is what the fuck is this symbolize? Which way is north? Do I really have to just keep trying? Alright, well, let's assume this is north. There's only 4 combinations if you know which way is north. So, okay, if this way is north, we'll just say it is. It'd be 5367. No, sorry. 5376. So, let's try 5376. We only have so many combinations. 5376. Okay, that way's not north. Okay, if this way is north, then let's assume this one is. This is north. Oh, maybe that's what this little marker above the 6 means, that it's north. Oh, maybe that is the case. Maybe I'm a fucking idiot. Well, let's try it. 6735. God damn it. I keep forgetting that the stupid goddamn motherfucking finger has to be the thing. 6735. Here we go. It's probably going to be the answer now. Watch. The last one I try. No? Are you fucking kidding me? Well, one of them has to be right. Am I not correctly fucking calling which one? North. East. It's this direction from north. Am I being an idiot? I hope not. Because this way would be west. Right? And this way would be south. Unless east and west are switched for some reason, but they shouldn't be. I'm very confused. Does the arrow above the 6 mean anything?
No.
Well, I understand what to do, but I don't know why I'm doing it wrong. This is very frustrating. I don't understand. What the fuck? 3675. How do I know which way is north? I don't understand. I don't understand. Fuck you. I'm gonna write it down. I'm gonna just write it down on a piece of fucking paper. I have a notepad. I got a pen. Let's fucking do it. Let's just do it. Where the fuck's my pen? I have a fucking pen. Don't even play with me right now. I know I got a pen. Don't even play right now, game. There's my pen. God damn it. No pads are ready, handy dandy, but my pen is not. All right, let's go. I'm just picking a random page. I guess I am. Let's just pick one. It's like here. All right. So, symbol looks like this. Drawn like that weird four thingy that it is. Okay. And then that direction, there's a seven. Seven over here. There's a six over here. There's a three over here, and there's a five over here. All right. That's all I need to know. So, if we're doing, and the it's northeast, west. This is the most work I think I've ever done for anything ever. All right, so if it's northeast, so it's 7, 5, 6, 3, or I'm just gonna go around the circle. It's 5, 3, 7, 6, or it's 3 east. If that's north, then east would be 6, and then 5, 7, and if 6 is north, then east is 7, west is 3, south is 5. Okay, so I'm pretty sure I tried all four of these combos already, but I'm going to try them all right now again, because what the fuck. So I have 7, 5, 6, 3. Tried that already. Didn't work. Alright. That was assuming that the 7 was north, obviously. Okay, so if the 5 is north, then it's 3, 7, 6. Okay. If the fucking 3 is north, then 6, 5, 7. Or, yeah, 6, 5, 7. Which is a negatory. Okay. And last but not least, if the 6 is north, we have 7, 3, 5. None of those work. Okay, so that stands to reason that the only thing that could be different is east and west are flipped, and that's the only thing I can think of. So if east and west are flipped, so I'm just going to take all four combinations I wrote down and just flip the two middle numbers because they're backwards. That's what I'm assuming I'm doing wrong here, because I literally just tried all four combinations, possible combinations, for the different norths, and none of them worked. So that stands to reason that the middle numbers have to be wrong, because north and south are going to be the same as long as you know. If one way is north, the other one's obviously south. So east and west can be flipped. There's a weird, maybe that's what that weird symbol means. It means something about the polarity being flipped or something. I don't know, man. Maybe that it's upside down. Maybe that's what the compass is signifying, that the whole thing's upside down. I don't know. Because if it was upside down, that would mean east and west are flipped, right? Makes sense. Or whatever. Backwards. Upside down, backwards, whatever. So, if I'm flipping the middle numbers, the first combination will be 7, 6, 5, 3. Okay. Next one. I'll tell you what, if one of these four doesn't work, I am completely stumped at what the fuck that middle thing means. Because I don't even know what other combinations you can do. So that one's not right. Alright. 3, 5, 6, 7. Nope. And one last combo. If it isn't right, then I'm not knowing what the fuck to do. 6, 3, 7, 5. Nope. What the fuck? What the actual fuck? What am I doing wrong? I don't understand. I literally just did every combination. Do I not know what north, east, south, and west is? I mean, I literally just tried every direction. Am I reading the numbers wrong? It's a 3, 6, 7, and a 5, right? This isn't a different number. Unless, oh. No, but this number is not a number upside down. I was thinking, like, what if it's upside down? Maybe this 6 is a 9. But if that's the case, oh, what if this 6 is a 9? But then this, what the fuck is this? This can't be something, this has to be a 7. Because a 3 and a 5 are not upside down. That wouldn't make any sense. Does it make sense that the 9 would be upside down? Is that what this means? If I switch to fucking... God, I'm so confused. Alright. So I'm going to operate on the assumption that the answer has a 9 in it. And I'm going to meet you when I have it right, I guess. Okay, so this combination is assuming that the 3 is north, which is which way the arrow is pointing on the compass. So this would be the most obvious one. So 3, 9, if that's east. West would be the 5. And 7 would be south. Son of a bitch! I should have known it was upside down. What's wrong with me? That's what the line on top of the 6 means. It means it's a 9 upside down. Fucking confusing ass puzzle. You... Ah! Whatever. I got a digital camera and a USB stick. Yay! Is that what that is? It looks like a key, but it's a USB stick. Alright. Cool USB stick that looks like a key. Digital camera. Cool, bro. Looks like there's no battery inside the digital camera. Well then. We should find one. Anyway, I'm guessing the key goes in here? Or... Wait. No. Really? I'm not exactly sure. Might be able to unlock the laptop. Oh, dur. There's a laptop here. Dur. 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 Forgot about the laptop. Just as I thought. Looks like I was able to unlock the lock with the USB stick. Now I need to put in the password. Oh, shit. Maybe the memo that was inside the desk drawer might be the laptop's password. Oh, yeah. I got it. It's the first letters of the days of the week. Okay. That's the password? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, meaning it's MTWTFSS. Wrong.
Huh? It's wrong!
I doubt it's that simple. So... Do I actually have to figure it out, or is it gonna... wonder if there are any other hints? Do I actually have to look at it? Where was it at? It was in this one, right?
We have no more business with this.
Sure we do. I need to look at it real quick. Uncompress password. Uncompress. Huh. Do I have to take a picture of it? Not power. It looks like let me use the regular. What? Sorry, I clicked through that accidentally. Well, regardless, it won't turn on unless there's a battery. So that's useless without a battery. We have scissors. Oh, maybe if we use the scissors. Cut through paper and cloth. There's no way to be able to cut through iron. Fair enough. I have an idea for you, Skizzers. Skizzers! I need you. Aha. No, wait, what? No? What else can I cut with Skizzers? Oh, can we cut open the doll? Ooh. Can we cut open the doll? Cut that doll. This plushie, if it's talking, it might be powered by a battery. Nailed it. Let's try cutting it open.
Enough already!
I didn't need any grannies.
What a loud thing.
Cut it open right away.
Also, there was something. Nice. Got them batteries, yo. Nice. Okay, so we got batteries. Use batteries. Now we can use the digital camera. Okay. Now do we take a picture of the thing? I'm assuming I have to take a picture of the thing, right? No more business. Okay, well, what the fuck are we taking a picture of? Are we just supposed to look at the digital camera? I should check the picture that's inside. Oh, okay. Oh, looks like a photo of a space poster that's posted on a wall somewhere. Hell yeah, it is. Sunday, Monday, Venus, Earth, Mars. See, it's not the days of the week. It's the planets. Got it. I wonder what that means, or what it means. It means combine that shit with the password, bro. Whoa. Based on the memo and the picture in the digital camera, the answer must be... Oh, shit. Hold on. I actually don't know. Hold on. I gotta look at the thing in here. I do have to look at this again. Now that I know it's the planets, what does that tell me? Wait, what does that tell me? SMVEMJS. Yeah, but what does that tell me? What does that tell me though? How do I know what the password is? Sun, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn. No planets are missing from up to Saturn. Only 7 planets here. Is the answer Uranus? That'd be pretty funny if it was. Let me just double check this. Okay, so obviously the Sun is the red one. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn. But uncompressed password? What does that even mean? I don't know what that even means. Uncompressed password? I don't know. Based on the answer must be... Oh, it's letters for sure. Oh. Oh no, there's numbers here too. There's letters and numbers? Oh, that just makes this more complicated, doesn't it? Fuck. Alright. Well, I think the answer is going to be Uranus. What do you guys think? That's why it's missing. Uranus is missing, dude. Yeah, I'm making a dumb joke. But that'd be hilarious, wouldn't it? Alright. Anus. A. This has got the worst fucking controls ever, by the way. It, like, scrolls faster, or it scrolls slower than you can press the button. That's bad controls. Okay. Uranus. We did it. See what I mean? If you press it that many times, it actually scrolls past it. That's silly. Nope, I got it wrong! Did you make sure you put it in correctly? Alright, let me just see if she has a fucking hint, because I'm like, what? So difficult. It's written in the memo, but it's not working, even if we put the first letters of the days of the week. Is it possible that Friday comes right after Monday? Is this game created by people who work so hard they don't even know the days of the week anymore? What are you saying? It has nothing to do with the days of the week. Understand, this memo is showing the solar system. I think we'll figure out the password if we arrange the planets and stars in order, and then number them. Oh. Huh? But what's the order of the solar system again? Wait. Place them in order. But this doesn't have all the... What? Mercury... Venus is a V. I'm confused, because V doesn't correspond... What? And put them in order? What? I'm confused. What do you mean, put them in order? That did not help me at all. What the fuck? Is that... What? I mean... Is it just telling me to put the names of the planets in order, like we did with the days of the week? Like Bonami was saying, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, so SMT, blah blah blah, like that. Should I put it in that order? So, okay. We know it's S. Stop it. S, Mercury, Venus. This is probably the answer. That's the only other thing I can think of. Like, I forgot the code that Minami guessed. So S, M, V, then E. This control sucks! Oh my god, it sucks. E. M again, because for Mars. And then Jupiter is next. And then last but not least is Saturn, which is another S. Got it. It should just automatically be like, boo doo doo doo, you got it. Fuck going over here to okay. You know, overshoot it anyways. Hey, look, we did it. Wait, what? There's more to this? Is this Othello? Hmm. Is this Othello? I don't know, is it? Hmm. Looks like Othello.
Leave it to me.
If you don't know something, don't overwork yourself. Feel free to ask me anytime.
I mean, I know what Othello is, but what do I have to play it? I don't... Wait, is there a code there? It looks like Othello to me. Is this telling me the code to the door? Somehow? I don't know. Maybe? I'm not good at Othello. I'll be able to get out of here. Othello is irrelevant. The laptop is showing a picture of the red lights on the device that's next to the iron bars. Look closely at the device blinks and compare it to the picture.
I see.
Oh. How? Only one thing in this room that can input a number into, right? Oh. Do I put the code over here? Oh, wait. What? Oh my god, the blinking lights, dude. Okay, so 3, 1, 2, 2. So how do I
Leave it to me.
How does that work? Oh, it's sideways. Right. Oh, I got it. Okay, 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 okay. I got it. So, okay. Let me double check which one it is. So, it's first and bottom, or left, right two, then the third, then the second two, and then the first two. Double check. First and 1, 3, 4, then it's three, right? 1, 3, 4, and then three. 1, 3, 4, and three. Okay. So, 1, 3, 4 is... Wait, what? How does that work? There's no option with 1, 3, 4. There's no option with three lights that's at all. Wow. What? That's even more confusing then. Because the only option that has three dots... Oh, wait. Well, what if they're black? I'm stupid. Okay, so that makes me think that the black ones mean that it's red. Okay, and that's the case. I think the bottom would be the leftmost, I would guess. So 1, 3, 4 would mean that the first number would be 4. The second number would be 2nd number would be, wait, that's the only one that has three lights lit? Wait, what? I am so confused by this. So confused by this. Am I looking at this wrong? Like, seriously, what? Hello? How do I do this? Hello? What am I looking at? I'm trying to figure out what the numbers are. Because this is 1, 3, 4, and then it's the third one, and then it's those two, and then those two. But, wow, what? This is a weird-ass fucking puzzle, man. Everything about this is so weird. I mean, even if it's upside down, it wouldn't even matter. I'm trying to find a spot where there's 3 and 1, and then there's also 1. But the only spots where there are 3... Oh, god damn it. I'm not trying to click through that quickly. I forget. I can't move my thing around. So the only ones that have 3 dots lit up or off at the same time, meaning there's only 1 dot lit or not lit, whatever white and black mean here, I don't know. There's the 2... The 1 and 8 are on the ends, right? 2 and... 4 are the 2 spots I need for the other one, but then that begs the question, where's the single lit one? Is the single lit one 2 or 4? Like, those are the only 2 ones that have the single lit dot, whether it's the white one being on. Oh god, like, what? I'm so confused by this. This situation is weird. I'm just looking at all these, like, what is wrong here? And I can't with this. Because even, like, with the 2 ends, right? It's the first 2, or the last 2, and then the first 2 are lit, right? The only one that has that is a 3. Is the idea here that certain combinations just equal a certain number? It doesn't matter which lights are lit? Because everything here is, like, I don't know. There's no situation where there is 1 black dot and 3 white dots except for number 7. So, what the hell? Like, I don't know. Or if in the opposite case, there's only the only 2 dot, 2 that have, or there's four, rather, that have three black dots and only one white dot. And that's one, one, two, four, and eight. So, what the actual goddamn hell is going on around here? I'm at a loss. I'm at a loss right now. I'm looking at this and I'm just, I don't know. I don't know. Do I have to look at this closely? This is still the same path. It's still doing the same thing as I could see when we weren't zoomed in. Could the lights on top of the unlocking device actually represent the number? If I use this signal book on the laptop to decipher...
Even if you know the number, how will you be able to input it?
There's only one thing in this room that you can input a number into, right? Oh, shit! I get it. I'm thinking of it like it's four different symbols. But what I should be thinking of it is as each one of those lights represents the digit. Oh, shit. Okay. So the first... Okay, I get it. So the first digit is beep, boop, boop, beep. So lit, not lit, not lit, lit. Got it. Okay, I'm gonna write this down. I still have my pen out from the last puzzle. So, okay, okay. So digit one is... We'll use circles for lit, X's for black. So it's circles, X, X, circle. Like, we'll use X's and O's. So O, X, X, O for the first digit, right? Let me double check that. O, X, X, O. Okay, second digit is O, or sorry, X, 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 O. X, X, O, okay. Third digit is... Sorry. Third digit is O O O X. O O O X. Alright, and the last digit is. Waiting for it to cycle one more time. I think it's O X O. O X O X. So it's O X O X. Alright, I think I got it now. Alright. Sorry. I was like, those four dots represent the things, but it doesn't match up anywhere. That's what that should have been my problem, and that was my problem. Okay, 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 okay. So now if I look at this, got it. So 0xx, okay, assuming that black equals black and red equals the white dot, then the first digit is 9, second digit is 8, third digit is 7, and the fourth digit is 0x0x, so that means it's white. Okay, so that's 5. 9875! That's my answer. Let's do it. 9875. We got two codes like it's fucking Virtue's Last Reward all over again, and I was just joking when I started this episode. This whole episode is gonna be me just putting in this code. That's just sad. That's just sad. 9875. Let's go! Did you hear something?
I got it!
So this is the unlocking device of the unlocking device!
Reusing gimmicks that we were already used does conserve energy. Sure does. So what did that do? What did that do? Oh, 30. Okay. Keyhole again, hmm?
Huh?
Did we ever get a key? I believe we've already searched this room from top to bottom.
So do we just stick the scissors in there? We could do that. I'm down.
Keyhole again, huh?
Huh?
Stick the USB stick in there.
Oh shit, really? I told you it looked like a key. I told you it looked like a key. Oh shit, there's a gun. What? Yay, looks like we cleared it.
Was that the whole thing? Like, there's not going to be like multiple rooms of this or anything?
With our powers combined, we were able to clear the life-threatening game.
Who cares about clearing it? Why does the exit feel like it's not opening?
Huh? What do you mean it won't open? Are you serious? It's not opening.
Didn't I just tell you that?
That's...
It's not just the exit. Even the door we entered from isn't opening.
Maybe the game isn't over yet.
Could it be?
Is there any chance that the thing I found earlier was just joking around?
Seems like you have something on your mind.
When I first arrived in this room, I received a letter.
A letter?
I'm sorry.
I thought it was just a prank, so I didn't have a chance to tell you.
Enough with the excuses. Hurry up and show it to me, you idiot.
Yes, it's this.
Solve the mystery of the final dead room, and you will obtain the right to play the life-threatening game. Wait, so we haven't even played it yet? That was just the room mystery? Oh, no. About the life-threatening game, it's life-threatening roulette. P.S. You are held liable for setting the roulette's difficulty. Depending on the difficulty, I've prepared special prizes. Make sure you don't overdo yourself. I see. So that's what it meant.
What does it mean?
It means the games up till now were just the opening act. From this point on is the real performance. Life-threatening roulette. That's probably like Russian roulette. See? A gun came out from there. Which means I have to use that to play Russian roulette, right? Holy shit.
Russian roulette?
Then allow me.
You can't!
No matter what, it's too dangerous!
Hey, Monami, there's something I wanted to ask you. In all honesty, I don't really understand the rules of Russian roulette.
Hey!
If that's the case, load one bullet into the cylinder and then spin it. After that, point the gun towards you and pull the trigger.
You can't.
Wait, you can't do that. There's a 1 in 6 chance you'll die.
A 1 in 6 chance of death, which means the failure rate is only 1/6. Hey, is that rule really okay?
Huh?
I mean, if there's only a 1/6 chance of failing, wouldn't the game be too easy? So, shouldn't it be the opposite? Remove one bullet from the gun and then use it while there are still 5 bullets loaded? If you do that, there'll be a 1/6 chance of success. Yep, that would definitely make it a more thrilling game.
That's...
What are you saying?
Let's give it a go. Wait, what? Oh my god, Nagito, you crazy, bro.
Hold on, Nagito. What are you doing?
What am I doing? Playing Russian roulette, obviously.
Duh.
I've only removed one bullet. So there's only a 1 in 6 chance that I'll survive.
You can't. Please stop.
He's the ultimate lucky student. He's gonna be fine.
It's not much of a talent, but even I have an ultimate level talent, you know? I'm the ultimate lucky student.
Exactly.
But if I can't win when there's only a 1 in 6 chance of success, then what kind of ultimate talent is that?
True that.
I mean, if my luck gets me killed like this, there's no way you can really call that talent. If I'm truly the ultimate lucky student, I need to survive here. Isn't that right?
Please, stop!
See, he's fine. I knew it. He's fine. That sound just now. That was the door unlocking, right? Haha, looks like we finally cleared the final dead room.
I'm scared of you, Nagito.
Really? Oh well, let's go. The arc gun should be just beyond that door. Okay, so now we're done? Aha, oh my god. Holy shit. They got everything up in here. What the hell? Ultimate weapon my ass. Ultimate fucking arsenal is what you meant to call it. Holy shit. This is the octagon, huh?
What a distorted room.
Wow.
Congratulations, Nagito.
Cool.
Oh, he's here.
Yeah.
Congratulations on clearing the final dead room. And you even challenged yourself at the highest difficulty with only a 1/6 chance of success.
Here.
I have a modest present for someone like you. Now then, this first.
Is this the Future Foundations file? Didn't we already get this when we were at the roller coaster?
Uh-huh.
Just think of it as an extension of that.
Extension?
Hey.
You, what are you given without permission? Let's see, and one more special prize. Here you go.
This crest, is this Host Peak Academy's?
That's right, this file. It contains your student profiles from your time at Host Peak Academy. Meaning, they're profiles that you guys don't even remember.
Our time at Host Peak Academy, huh? But after all this time, I still can't believe it.
What?
You mean that matter concerning your stolen school memories?
I mean, a no-good person like me actually spent time with everyone else at Host Peak Academy? No, that's impossible. If that's true, how did I feel? Surely I would have spent my time feeling ashamed of myself for being in the presence of such greatness.
Jeez, whether you're upbeat or depressed, I still don't understand you at all.
Phew.
Oh well, anyway, I'm passing this along to you. How you use it is up to you.
Thanks. I'll take a long look at it later. So, if I look at these profiles, I'll be able to find out what Hajime's hidden talent is too. He'll probably be happy about it. Yay! Someone like me was finally useful. Huh? What are you laughing about?
Well, I just thought it was ironic. Out of everyone here, someone like you was the one to obtain Host Peak Academy's student profiles. I'm not sure if you're lucky or unlucky.
What does that mean?
Well, it looks like things are gonna get interesting. Yes, Nagito, you might be the one who makes things much more interesting.
I don't really know what you're talking about.
Hey, what are you planning? What's written in there?
Lie.
Anyway, Manami.
Hey!
No cheating! You haven't reached the end yet! Huh? I mean, you haven't played Russian Roulette yet! But Nagito already did it.
No.
Get over here! Revenge of the Final Dead Room!
Whoa.
No!
Coercion!
Jeez, they're gone. In the end, I still don't understand what Monokuma was even talking about. But for now, I'll leave this file for later. First, I need to investigate this room. It's not like I know how to get out of here. Okay, there are all sorts of fun things going on here. Oh my god, this room is huge! Is this food? Dude, tell me this is food. Refrigerator here? I wasn't expecting to find drinks in it, but when I opened the door and peeked inside, I see. There are poisons stored in here. Oh god, it's literally every weapon you could want. You could secretly kill everyone with poison. In a way, it can be considered the most powerful weapon. But in that case, you'd have to ignore the rules. Regardless, it's slightly different than an ultimate weapon. Something called ultimate should make my heart dance with joy. Okay. What is this? The escape room? Or the escape hatch, I mean? There's a door. On the floor? Isn't this the first floor of Strawberry House? Could this door lead underground? Based on the sketch, there shouldn't have been a bunker. No, maybe what lies beyond this door. Things are finally getting interesting. Alright, well, we'll check that out in a minute. In the meantime, we got more things to look at, like all these weapons over here. Axes, swords, hammers, metal wires. There's a lot of items here that could be used as weapons. But I don't see anything that looks like it could be the ultimate weapon. I wonder where the so-called ultimate weapon is. I don't know. Let's check out this window over here. A window? Why is there only one window in a place like this? Looks like there's some kind of hidden meaning to it. But in actuality, what could it mean? In my mind, I entertained various possibilities as I walked slowly toward the window. And then, the moment I peeked out that window... Huh? This is... what I actually saw outside that window. It was completely different from any possibility I had in mind. Whoa, dude. What? I see, so that's what it was. What I saw outside this window, if I start piecing it together and think about it, yeah, I see. It seems I'm finally starting to get a large perspective of what the funhouse with... perspective of the funhouse with this. Wait, what? He gets the perspective of the funhouse? Amazing! As expected of a place that cannot be reached unless you clear the final dead room. Thanks to how I arrived here, all the separate pieces seem to have connected together in one fell swoop. Chain reaction culminating in the truth, all thanks to just one clue. I know that's not now's not the time to enjoy things, but this is definitely a good feeling. Especially that window. That's right, everything became connected from there. Thanks to that window, I realized the mystery of the ultimate weapon and the funhouse. Now all I have to do is tell everyone about this. Before I do that, I should finally take a look at the file I received from Monokuma. Especially if it's everyone's student profiles from their time at Host Peak Academy. That's important. Cautiously opened the file and read it carefully, taking care not to miss a single letter. Carefully. Huh? Oh my god, we're not going to get any of this info because it's Nagito, right? It's not actually Hajime.